Good morning and welcome to your Farm and Home Show. My name is Joanna Coles, and this morning we're visiting with Chris Schott, the Barron County Extension Agent for Agriculture and Natural Resources. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning.
Now, Chris, today we are going to talk about Christmas trees. Mm-hmm. They are such a fun way to make, you know, memories with the family, but also support local farmers.
Sure. The day after Thanksgiving, I mean, my family, we get into Christmas in a big way. I get into Christmas and I get excited thinking about Christmas. So, day after Thanksgiving, we go generally to a local Christmas tree farm. And we've gone here in Warren County, we've gone to Barron County. And we cut one and take it back and get started with it.
Absolutely. And there are some benefits to having a live Christmas tree.
Sure, there is. It's, you know, like I said, we're going Black Friday, okay, the day after Thanksgiving. And we leave it up the entire time through Christmas, take it down pretty quick afterwards, but have never had any issue with it drying out because, I mean, it was fresh, right? Some of the Christmas trees, you know, when you go to purchase them at a store and they've already cut, you just got to look at those and really kind of inspect and bend those needles and stuff just to make sure that they're going to stay up as long as you want them up.
And you know, we have some really great Christmas tree farms in the area. They even have some activities, some photos with Santa. And it's really nice, but you can't wait until Christmas Eve.
No.
You need to
go pretty quick. And most of them now have websites. We've had some weather the past couple of years that have been detrimental to some of the folks. So the Christmas tree supply actually here in South Central Kentucky has been kind of short, okay? So you got to, you know, check out their website, check out their Facebook page, make sure they've got, you know, if you pick them up the phone, give them a call. I think that's really important, you know, just to make sure they've got it. But you can't wait till the last minute, so for sure. And you got to be ready to go.
So you kind of have to know where you are. You know, if you're
right,
ready to put one up, you want to go early. But maybe if you want to wait a little bit longer, you could probably go to a retailer.
Sure.
And get one of those live Christmas trees. But there are some considerations when we get a live Christmas tree.
I think the number one thing is size. And we don't want to have, we've all seen probably the Christmas Vacation thing, you know, okay. What I like about most of the Christmas tree farms, they will give you a stick, a PVC pipe or something that's got marks on it. Know what kind of size tree you want. And that is not only height, but, you know, diameter around too. Pick out the spot in your house. You know, we generally use a corner, okay, all right, which also, you can think about a tree. If maybe if it's not 100% on one side, you're going to put that in there. We use a corner because it's away from the heating vents and things of that nature. You want to shut those down, keep it away from the fireplace, that kind of stuff, keep it from drying out. So think about where you're going to put the tree.
Absolutely. And then there is some maintenance that goes along with a live Christmas tree.
Right. You've got to, I mean, you know, that's a good job for the kids, right? Feed the dog and check the water in the Christmas tree, right? And it does need to be checked, okay, daily. You know, if you got a pet in the house, you'll probably hear them drinking out of it. So that's, you know, make sure you're checking that every day. And again, bending those needles and making sure it's not drying out, looking on the floor. If you have to start sweeping up a lot of needles off the floor, then your tree's drying out.
All right. And that can be hazardous.
That sure can be hazardous. Yes. You know, and another thing, and you can check with your local fire department. Some of them have a program where they dip the tree in a fire retardant material, which really helps slow that down, you know, the dry down. Just pick up the phone. Don't call 911. Call the fire department number. Check with a local fireman. You know, they can help you out with that, definitely. And again, little things like making sure the vents are turned off and things of that nature. The LED bulbs that we use now on Christmas trees have really helped out because they don't produce the heat. Like the big old bulbs when I was a kid that would burn you if you touch them. Okay, all right. I mean, even they've even got some of the heirloom type bulbs, the bubble bulbs and stuff now that are LED. They work a little bit different, okay? So that works good. If you're planning on a live Christmas tree, I would definitely say probably invest in those LED bulbs.
Absolutely. Well, Chris, appreciate you bringing the information. And you can find Christmas tree farms on Kentucky Farms Are Fun or look up Kentucky Proud if you're not familiar with those. And
right,
they list them right there.
Sure enough.
All right, Chris, thanks for the information. And we certainly appreciate you watching the Farm and Home Show. If you have any questions about maintenance and care of your live Christmas tree or would like a little bit of help of finding where to find that farm to take your family and make those memories, just give us a call at the Extension office. Thanks for watching and have a great day.